Hey everybody, it's Richard at RMAutodiag, and today we're going to have a look at a Vauxhall Vivaro with some fuel pressure issues. Let's get into it. Okay, so as you can see, we've got the flashing red engine management light on, and it doesn't start. Go onto the scanner here, go into the engine, let's see what codes we've got. I did scan this a minute ago, so we should have some fuel pressure codes in it. Okay, so we got that 1809 fuel pressure sensor circuit, and we've got a heater plug circuit fault as well. We're not too worried about that one, that's not going to cause it not to start. So if we clear the codes, initiate cleared, click code clearing, continue. And as you can see, they don't go away. So let's have a look at a bit of live data. See if we can customize this down. So we're looking for fuel pressure, fuel rail pressure, right there. Let's have a look at it. Okay, so we got zero bar. Let's give it a crank. Right, okay, so that's completely non-changing. There is a bit of up and down cadence with that crank. We're not too concerned with that right this second, but we'll need to find out why we're getting zero pressure at this pressure sensor. So let's get under the bonnet and do a few quick tests. Right, okay, so we've got our fuel pressure sensor down here on the rail. I've got it disconnected here. So we've got three pins, so we're expecting a 2 5-volt feeds and one earth. And one of those 5 volts will get pulled down every time you plug it back in, and that's what's the signal wire. So we'll get set up with a multimeter and we'll take some readings. Okay, so first thing we notice is we've already had some wiring damage here, but let's check it. So we'll go for one of the either end to see if we've got an earth, and we'll check the other two. So we're expecting to see 5 on the meter. We've got 5 there on one, and we've pretty well got 5 on the other, so we're happy with that. We're happy that the earth works as well. So next thing is we're going to plug it in and we're going to see what the voltage does. We're going to go for the middle one, so I'm going to just sort of guess that middle ones are usually the signal voltage back, and we'll see what that goes to. As I say, this is a circuit low code, so if it gets pulled straight down to 0 volts when it plugs in, then I think that's going to be our issue. Let's see if I can get this probed back down the back of here. Right, so we're on 5 volts there. And we're going to plug it in. That's it plugged in there now, and we've pulled that 5 volts straight down to 20 millivolts, 30 millivolts. That's no good. I think that's where we're getting our code, and what I'm going to do from there is I'm going to get a different sensor. We're going to plug it in and see if we don't get our code. Actually, what we're going to do is we're going to get a decade box and we're going to put it in line, and we'll see if we can clear the code first. Right, okay, so we've got a decade box. We're set to about 600 ohms, and I've got it attached up in line with the earth wire and the signal wire in the middle. And if we go over to the scan tool, sorry about the glare, we've got 424 psi of fuel pressure, so we can make a change on that. If we come inside, we have a look here. We have no flashing light anymore. So if we exit that, codes are gone as well. Just got the heater plug one. So we've got live data back, codes have gone, and we've got no more flashing light. I turn the ignition on and off. The red stop light isn't there anymore. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get a fuel pressure sensor, we'll put it in, and we'll see if this will prime up and start now. Right, okay, so got a new Bosch sensor, fitted the real pressure sensor. It's just a 27 mil, pretty easy to do, just unscrew it and screw it back in. I've cleared the codes, I've primed up the diesel system. This has got an electric pump in the tank, so that's quite convenient. And what I'm gonna do is if we go into data, as you can see, we do have a reading here now. If I turn and start it on the key, and we've got fuel pressure. The van is running. We've got a rev. So we're all happy with that. You can see the fuel pressure going up there when we're revving it. So that's all solved. So this was a complete non-start. We had the fuel pressure codes saying circuit low. We had the sensor was shorted internally, pulling it down to ground. So we did that bypass test, and then we got a new sensor. And yep, we're all good, we're all started, we're running. So we'll take it out for a quick test drive, and that should be it. No problems there. So, yep, thanks for watching, and come along for the next one. Cheers.